how to play bass.
Token, how many times do we have to go through this? You're black. You can play bass.
I'm getting sick of your stereotypes.
Be as sick as you want. Just give me a goddamn bass line.
In my brain, love, these hoes are sad.
I have ADHD and I don't want to clean my room. So instead, I made an Ariana Grande sock puppet. Check this.
Thing about being a system content creator is inevitably there will be interjects of you.
An alter of an alter? Alterception!
But yeah, after seeing this little cretin running around my Discord server, I figured I should have some proper profile pictures, just in case. So we made an Aspen interject straw page, complete with a wall of cringe, documenting every system who has an Aspen. Of course, I wouldn't wish that on my worst enemy, but I do have the link in my Discord if you need it for some reason.
Well, you didn't say they were from the Undercity? What difference does that make? They're dangerous!
You don't get it, you just don't get it.
You've already forgotten even though I just said it.
Wait, I thought you were allergic to peaches. Well, I think I might be, but I keep going back and forth. What do you mean? Well, a lot of other people's allergies are a lot worse than mine, and I haven't been officially diagnosed. What happens when you eat peaches? My chest and my neck break out in hives, and my throat gets really itchy. But you don't think you're allergic? Well, I haven't been to an allergist to confirm it. Don't you think you should accommodate yourself and not eat peaches, whether a doctor has told you you're allergic or not? That just feels really performative. Yes, you can stim with food, and that is what people are doing when they eat their feelings. But that's not the only way that you can stim with food. Like, if I'm sensory seeking, I will find myself in the kitchen restlessly digging through the cabinets looking for, like, the perfect snack. So, for example, some of my favorite things to eat are, like, cheese and crackers, chips and dip, like, food that I have to put together and that also has multiple textures going on at once. I also really love flaming hot fries and rosé because, like, that combo just tickles my brain and, like, the spicy hot stuff clears my sinuses and it makes me feel like that, like, sweaty top of the head feeling, but like it does the same thing sour candy does. So sour candy also is a good stim. And foods with really intense flavors push negative thoughts and emotions out of or to the back of the brain. And food can release different chemicals in our brain, like chocolate and serotonin. I'm sure I'm just scratching the surface on this subject.
Number one reason people fake claim is denial. Two types of denial, personal to them, and systemic denial. Personal, meaning that they are likely hiding from their own trauma. And us living our truth challenges their protective mechanisms. Or they really haven't experienced it before, so they're in denial about it even being possible that someone could be abused. In systemic denial, we live in a society that only wants to acknowledge good things and positive experiences. And completely denies the fact that childhood abuse is very common. Way, way more common than anyone wants to admit.
But it includes defending ourselves against the angels.
Are you fucking high?
They can be killed.
Yeah, that knife lady, Camaro car fight, killed one.
Wait.
I'm Kokon, so I must be a DRD system. I'm 4 and 6 years old, but I'm in an adult body, so I can drink alcohol.
I'm me again. Feels like it's been years.
I'm scared,
or that he's socially impaired,
or that he only likes to tinkle in the woods.
What?
Talk about the bullies over at Fake Disorder Cringe. Because they look real bad when they fake claim real systems. I wrote a script for this last night, but I reread it this morning and thought that I had some good points, but I needed to say the quiet part out loud. So here's the quiet part. The people at Fake Disorder Cringe are using fake claiming as a way to taunt people with real mental illness. This subreddit has gone beyond making fun of people for faking and turned into a place to bully systems and other people with visible mental illness into behaving how they think we should. Anyone who posts on Fake Disorder Cringe has decided that they're an authority on who is or isn't faking their mental illness. They're worse than armchair psychologists because they don't want to help. They just want to feel superior. Anyone who knows anything about systems knows how detrimental it can be in denial. Denial is a bad spiraling symptom, and it can feel impossible to get out of. Do you know how easy it is to fall into denial when you end up on a subreddit made for people faking their disorders? Let me make it clear, it is bad to fake mental illness. I wish there was a way that we could know when people were faking, but we can't. So here's what we need to do. We need to take people at their word so we're not fake claiming real systems. So we're not harming real people who are doing nothing wrong. You do not get to decide who is or isn't faking. And it's disgusting to say that you stand up for mental illness in any form whatsoever if you're fake claiming anybody. If you had 1 ounce of empathy in your body, you would not fake claim anyone. You would understand how detrimental that could be. You would not want to take the chance that you're fake claiming a real system because you would understand how hard it can be to be in denial. But you don't care, do you? Because you never cared. Because this has always been about the fake internet points for you.
People at Fake Disorder Cringe are using fake claiming as a way to taunt people with real mental illness. So let's do something about it. Today, I'm gonna take one for the team and show y'all how to report a subreddit. I realize that this is gonna put a target on my back, but it needs to be done. You can see right here in Reddit's content guidelines that communities and users that incite violence or that promote hate based on identity or vulnerability will be banned. And if you click on identity or vulnerability, it brings you to this, where it says, some examples of hateful activities that would violate the rule, subreddit community dedicated to mocking people with physical disabilities. So while this is about mental disabilities and not physical ones, it is essentially saying right there that this subreddit is not allowed. So here's how to report it.
Google Reddit submit a request and it's the first one there. Scroll down and select community help. This is the form we'll fill out. Under community concern, put I want to report a subreddit for violating community guidelines and fake disorder cringe under the subreddit. For a primary reason, I put hate, but after reading some of your stories, you could definitely put harassment too. Fill out the rest of the form and submit at the bottom.
My last video on this subreddit got over 10,000 views, and if even a small portion of those people made a report, we could get something done. Besides reporting, you can also help by sharing this video or just leaving a nice comment. I am sure that once bullies catch wind of what's going on, they'll be here to hate on me. I've also told my roommate about what's going on, so they're prepared to help me if things get too bad. Really sad that I have to take that precaution just because I'm showing people how to report a subreddit, but that just goes to show how badly this subreddit needs to go.
Way to tell you, have you noticed I've been gone?